I'm in my setup for the Regeneron STS competition.
I still can't believe this is happening tomorrow.
I'm really looking forward to meeting all the other finalists and opening this with them.
We got these portraits of ourselves. This is me writing for a newspaper.
I'm so excited, honestly. Just seeing all of the 40 other finalists, it suddenly became that much more real.
Even though Regeneron STS has moved virtual this year, I still had found many, many ways to connect with my fellow finalists.
And we're in weird circumstances now, where we can't physically meet each other, but I think that makes our bond that much more special.
I think STS is one of the most amazing and best opportunities to meet other like-minded people.
As STS finalists, we have talent, we have inspiration, and most importantly, we have dreams of a better world.
Finding out that I became a finalist was the biggest moment of my life. My project is focusing on racial disparities in healthcare, and I really felt like making progress was something that I could contribute to.
You're doing something you're passionate about that has the possibility of impacting other people's lives. And so this is what motivates me to do research.
After the Parkland shooting, I started to see the effects of gun violence in my own life. So I decided to turn to machine learning to help solve this problem.
The eventual goal that I hope to solve is to mitigate toxic comments and hateful content in online media.
We really are the future as this younger generation. We are the problem solvers.
Being an STS finalist really means to me serving as an inspiration for aspiring high school students interested in research as well.
I want to assure the young scientists of the world that no matter what challenges you face, don't lose the scientific side of you, because that inquiry and that curiosity will always be able to get you through whatever problems you face.
If something doesn't make sense, never stop asking why, and one day you'll find a solution.
I worked on a problem that I thought was basically completely understood already, but it turns out that there's still new directions to look into.
We are able to build upon the things that have already been discovered or created by the generation before us, but expand on it.
Despite the pandemic, and there's a lot of public health issues and social justice issues, I feel it's still important for young people to be involved in science with what you can do from home, what you can learn about, what you can educate people with.
All the finalists at the STS are demonstrating their resilience this year by telling COVID that they aren't going to stop doing what they're doing just because they might not be able to leave their homes.
So today was officially the last day of judging. That's 3 days of the most bizarre questions I could have never imagined, but it was super fun getting to meet all those judges.
They asked really thought-provoking questions that I'd never really heard before, but really got me more interested in math and science.
Sometimes I knew the answer, sometimes I didn't know the answer at all, and some of them, I don't think there was a right answer.
Today was also really cool because we had an alumni dinner with a couple of STS alum.
We were able to talk to Dr. Zhang, who revolutionized gene editing with his development CRISPR, which one of the finalists this year actually uses. It's really, really cool to see the legacy being passed down the STS finalists.
My favorite part was during the show and tell game to talk with other finalists about our personal interests and hobbies.
One student set up a scribble game for us to play. And there's a couple more students who are setting up online games for show and tell later in the week.
we just finished our escape room, so I think everybody's feeling good, guys.
Today's event was geocaching, and it was super fun. I definitely had some very challenging clues, some very small in size and in very hard places to find.
Okay, so I think it might be here. Oh, yay, I did it.
Today was public day. I just got out of the chat room where I was able to answer questions from the public, and it was just really awesome.
I really enjoyed the primetime visits today. Something that the science news people said that was really helpful was that we should assume that our audience is smart, but they don't have the right words to understand your project.
From being an STS, I've learned how important science is to all of our daily lives.
I really learned that sometimes we really need collaborations to solve different types of scientific problems.
Especially with the pandemic happening right now, what Regeneron is showing us is that as long as we believe in ourselves and as long as we are confident, that we can achieve anything.
I just wanted to say thank you to
all of the people who made this experience possible, who made this week one of the best weeks of my life.
Whenever there wasn't something going on, we were always on call, laughing together, having fun, playing games or telling each other stories. And I think that's really what makes STS so special, are the connections that last a lifetime.
Through what has been the most transformative week of my life has shown me that even though we're all different in our areas of science, we're all united by our passion for somehow using this tool to make a world a better place.
Saying that 2020 has been challenging is an understatement, but these young scientists and engineers are resilient. They show grit, they have shown determination, they have shown adaptability, and I'm incredibly proud of them.
Your experience at the Science Talent Search is one step on your future path and one demonstration of the powerful and important things you can achieve.
And now, the announcement of our top 10 winners. The third place winner, Brendan Crotty.
This is amazing. This is something that I feel like I've worked so hard for, and winning, to me, is justification. Everything I've done meant something.
The second place winner, JAGDEEP BHATIA.
Advice I'd like to give is don't be intimidated by any challenging problem that you might face. It's something that will take time, but I can tell you it'll definitely be worth it.
And the first place winner, LILLIAN K. PETERSEN.
Now is a great time for science because this pandemic has opened all of our eyes to just how important it is. We have to work together to solve these really big issues.